Before we dive into the session material, let's talk a bit about storing or persisting data in Android. First of all, why do we bother to persist things at all? This is the era of the connected cloud. Why don't we always fetch from there? It's really nice to not start the app and see loading, or even worse, like this, a blank screen. The faster people can use an app, the more it will be used. Obviously, if one has to select refresh to get it to display anything, that would be particularly bad. Another reason to persist our data is that using any radio is detrimental to the battery life of the device, especially the cellular radio. Many users aren't on metered data plans or maybe roaming when they want to use your app. All those unnecessary data fetches can add up. There are still lots of places that don't have a network connection available. One of the prime advantages of having a mobile app is being resistant to bad or non-existent network conditions. After all, you never know where the user will want to use your app. As you might expect, Android stores your persistent data in the file system. These files can be stored in internal storage that is private to your app. They can also be stored in shared or external storage. On older Android devices, this shared storage was actually on an external memory card. Today, most Android devices only emulate this card so that there is the shared external storage apps need available on the device. Some Android devices have emulated shared storage and secondary external storage. Android 4.4 KitKat added an API to allow developers to access this secondary external storage. We're going to focus on internal storage in this class. Check the instructor notes to learn more about Android storage locations. As I mentioned before, Android persists data into the file system. It does provide two functional layers on top of the file system in the form of shared preferences and Sqlite. The shared preferences class provides a general framework that allows you to save and retrieve persistent key-value pairs of primitive data types, such as booleans, floats, ints, longs, and strings. Shared preferences is used by the Android preference activity to store our settings data, such as the location. Why store things in an Sqlite database? After all, Android supports both raw files and shared preferences. For the same reason that it's inefficient to find things if you throw your clothes in a pile on the floor. Storing things in an Sqlite database helps you organize and find data easily thanks to the power of indexing in tables. An Sqlite database looks something like this fragment from our weather database. Note that not all fields are represented. We can perform queries using SQL against this database, such as the select statement here, which returns the weather on the specified date, similar to what we'll want to do for the detail view. We can use a slightly more complex query to return a range of dates, which is similar to what we do on the main forecast list view.